Okay, Miss Sunkee Angel's line one. I don't know. Can somebody give me Sunkee Angel? It's a line one. Who is about fuck? Oh, thank you, Miss Sunkee Angel. My sister. Oh, God.
I just pissed on the floor because I'm about to. What's going on? What's up? 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 What Lord.
And so you did that as your alter ego, not
yes.
Okay. Why was that part of why you did it?
Say what?
So why did you do it as an alter ego instead of doing it as...
Hold on 1 second. Let me plug up my charger for my phone with that. I'm literally just getting back from the damn store. It's on the floor.
I'm sorry for bombarding you like that.
It's okay. Let me first... Wait, well, go ahead. Say what you're going to say.
So why did you do it as a jacket instead of doing it as the Sunkee Angel?
Because... Actually, I did a show mix when I performed down in Atlanta. So okay. I believe in tackling certain issues and hitting their ass on stage. Fuck internet, fuck all that dumb shit. If I'm going to do it, I'm going to put it in my fucking show and shoot that shit back and dance on stage. So I decided to do it because it was funny and everybody thought it was hilarious. So I thought to do it as Auntie Jackie.
Have you ever been in a situation where you were told about a band?
Yes, but the thing was, I was in the wrong and I wasn't right at the time. I didn't have my name changed on my ID. I was still living my life as male, so technically I couldn't argue that because I was living my life as a guy, so.
I'm glad.
Some people saying it's an echo.
That might be me, because I had you on a thing. That was because I had you on a little tree. And so what that does is it echoes back into that. I took it off.
Okay.
So my question is, so we were talking about that earlier today, as far as the whole situation. But let me ask you something. So is it with transition, what would you say level or stage are you on? Are you fully transitioned or what? For those that might not know. And I know this is not what we even come here to talk about, because
I'm an open book, but some things I feel like is not necessarily everybody's business. Because if I'm saying I'm a woman, and that's really the end. However, I'm not completely where I want to be in my transition, but it does not negate the fact that I live my life as female. So,
gotcha.
And I respect your question. You know, I respect you. I love you. I ain't got a problem with you, Shane.
Right. I appreciate that, because I turn the interview mode automatic. I don't know why I do that. I think I'm just a good interviewer. I think that's what I need to be, because I'm just good at it. And it automatically goes into it. I just find people, and you're an interesting person. I should have done this. I should have actually interviewed you for real. Whenever we get a chance, we definitely do that. I got to set that up. But because even with that, I've thought about a million more questions I would like to ask. And I ain't good, and this will last all night. But so thank you for bringing it down. Especially with somebody, let me pose something to you. I don't know. I think you may have heard this before, or if not, you might know more about it than me. Let me ask something. What do you give as far as advice for people in this life that might not? Because is it psychological? Do you think? Because that's the thing we were talking about today. Whether transitioning, is it really psychological? Is it more like a physical need, or what is it?
It's for me, I can't, everybody's transition is different, but for me, my transition has always been, I've always felt like a woman on the inside from when I was little. It was something was not right for me. I can't, you know, everybody has their own different definition of what trans is, but I knew something was not right. I didn't dress out with the boys. I never felt comfortable around guys. Follow what I'm saying. I never felt comfortable with being in that space with them because I was always with the girls. I felt like a girl. I felt out of place. You know what I'm saying? So, yes.
Moving from Alabama to LA. What was that? That's a transition in itself.
That was crazy. To me, I had to get the hell out of Alabama. You know how it is in the South. Coming from Diggy Doo, coming from that male persona that everybody got to know. And love. They grew to love. A lot of people love Diggy Doo, but at the same time, that was me living a lie, trying to please my family. And I could not live that truth any longer because deep down, I knew what it was. I was in a damn club shaking harder than the bitches. The niggas would be all eyes, 24/7. You know how I go. I was all eyes. I couldn't. It was difficult for me psychologically because here I am with sideburns talking about I'm looking for a fabulous girl. Montgomery, Alabama. Knowing damn well I ain't looking for no fabulous girl. I'm looking for the nigga. I'm looking for a fabulous nigga, like, for real. You know what I'm saying? So it was difficult to come from that space, not where everybody knew me as Diggy Doo,
right,
to be able to come into my true self. And I felt like I could not do that in Alabama. I felt like I had to leave. It was a spiritual thing for me as well. I had to get out of Alabama to really become who I am on the inside.
Right. So speaking of that, you said, okay, this is your... I've never seen you done or seen anything from you when it comes to the mat. I don't know if you're just keeping this private. And if that's the case, let me know. But what's the love life like? Like, are you dating somebody? Or are you single? Or are you... What's the thing with that? I don't even know what's your type. You like them tall? The most short?
Well, you know, I guess I'll just piss on them. So, to be honest, I'm not really... I'm really focused on my career, to be honest. Like, I don't really have time to be trying to let... I feel like sometimes that can be a distraction. Now, I've met certain people who are also in the industry who have made me feel like the woman that I feel like on the inside, and I felt like it could go somewhere. But the thing is, sometimes I don't know if they know, and I don't believe in coming on to a man. You know, I just don't believe, with certain people not being accepting of trans women. They have to come up to me. I'm not going to ever disrespect no man because I feel like everybody has the right to be engaged with who they want to be engaged with, right?
Right.
So there have been a lot of situations where I've seen a lot of men attracted to me, and a lot of them like me. A lot of them don't like trans, and that's okay. I'm beautiful. I'm not going to force nobody to be with me. Right. But to be honest, I'm focused. I'm fucking my music, and I'm fucking these tracks over here. That's the only thing I'm really focused on. All that other shit, I ain't got time, to be honest. Like, I've overcome so many different things, and I feel like it would distract me at this point. Now, however, if somebody comes into my life and they are ready to accept all of me, and I do mean all of me, I don't know who would be really ready to take that position. It would take somebody who's definitely very, very open-minded to be with Sunkee Angel.
Awesome. I like it.
Yes.
Sunkee, you have made a list.
I saw.
Congratulations.
And I don't know what the fuck. Yes, because I don't know what the fuck for. I don't know what for.
This is the...
I honestly don't know. Jaguar, let me say this. And let me first, before anybody, because I know it's a lot of messy people, let me first say, this is not no attack. I'm not going to get on here and just start coming at her. Because to be honest, that was never me anyway. That was never me. So I know people can take stuff and spend things and take it how they want to take it and make things something that is not. But I don't know why the hell my name on the list. I've seen you talking about her. I've seen people saying stuff. Yes, I can laugh. I've laughed. Shit is funny. I've seen people say, well, you was in the comment section. I can laugh. The fuck? Bitch, right. When I can't laugh.
Right.
Not only that, when we had our history in the past, because to be honest, I don't think about her. I don't go around talking about Jaguar. I don't go around keeping her name in my mouth. My auntie just passed. Like, life is hitting me. I don't have time to be, you know what I'm saying? I don't have time to be on social media worried about what somebody else doing, her or anybody else. To be honest, they ain't put no money in my pocket. Now I'm concerned about my health, trying to stay positive. The whole pandemic going on. I don't have time to be. Definitely. I'm on some grown folk shit for real. You don't see me on social media sending people over there. So I read that. And I'm like, what the fuck is she talking about? Saying I sent some people to a page. Jaguar, that's a lie. I've never sent nobody to your page. If anything, they're sending people to my page, and they've been sending people to my page. And I said, you know what? I wasn't gonna get on here. But I said, you know what? It's time to speak for a lot of things, not just with this. When it comes to family, I'm addressing any bully or anybody out there that's in the room that keep trying to come for my head when I have not done anything to them that's solid enough to keep my name in their fucking mouth or trying to whatever. But this is internet shit. I don't get caught up into this shit. It ain't serious to me. She said shots fired. Subliminals, what? Shots ain't fired until it's physical. I don't go, what, you gonna shoot them through the internet? You gonna shoot them through a text? Like, I don't understand why it's my name keep coming up. What you got going on with her ain't got nothing to do with me. So
nothing.
My name out your mouth. I don't.
Nothing.
What have I talked to you about her?
Never.
So what the fuck is she talking about? As a matter of fact, I've tried to bring this community together because, and I don't want to get emotional because I am a very emotional person, but I've tried to bring this community together because I know it's a lot of toxicity in this community. And it be these same people that's got these large-ass platforms coming for younger girls or people that they see coming up, and I don't understand the shade. I've been shaded by a lot of people. I'm going to keep from trying to mention a lot of names, but this is my experience. A lot of older girls I've met people, I've been called Jesus. Like, it's like, what the fuck? Like, respect me. Respect me the same way I respect you. Why are you shading me when I'm in the same community as you? I want it to feel somewhat of what I thought community should be. When I came into myself and I thought that the community would be loving and kind and understanding, I found out real quick that that wasn't the case. Now, I'm not saying that it's everybody because it's not. However, there have been a lot of situations where I have tried to collab, and it's like, we both in LA, why let's collab? This is from my heart and my soul. I honestly really fuck with, like, this ain't no cap, no nothing. When I first saw Jaguar, to be honest, I said, this bitch is crazy. Auntie Jack is crazy. I reached out to her for the single that I dropped called I'm Not a Label, where I came out about my status, me being HIV positive, which I don't hide. I'm an advocate for it. And I said, you know what? Let me take this opportunity to try to see if I can bring the girls together. So I reached out to her. I said, hey, I want you to send me a clip saying, hello, my name is, I'm Jaguar, and I'm not a label. She did that. We talked, chopped it up. It wasn't nothing. If it was something from my end, first of all, I would have never hit her up. If I thought it was going to be anything, I would have never reached out to her.
Right.
I'm not coming in the door shading no fucking body. It's when I get in the door with these people, and at that particular time, there have been times where I was trying to seek friendship. I'm not going to lie, because I was in a very vulnerable place with going through family issues and not being accepted. So I'm kind of somewhat looking for somewhat of a community, somewhat sisterhood, I guess, whatever you want to call it. So there were things I talked to her about that I confided in her about, and we began to talk on the phone every now and then. And, you know, we just kind of grew. We went places. There were times I didn't have money. She gave me food. She made sure I had food and everything. It's a lot of stuff that I went through a lot of people don't know about, because I really never really wanted to go too deep into it. But since my name is coming up, I'm in a place now where I'm just like, you know what? I'm fucking tired of this shit. I'm just going to go and say what I need to say and keep it the fuck on moving. Because it ain't no beef. It's not no beef over here. I eat beef. I'm not at her. I'm not in the street chasing her down. Like, it's not that type of shit. But however, there have been a lot of things that has happened, like, that made me very, very uncomfortable. And I don't know. If me saying you made me uncomfortable is hate, then what the fuck? How are you going to take me saying? Let me tell you something. When I first came to Jab, when I told her that I was going to get my name changed, because at the time, this was back 2017. This was years ago. We in 2020.
Right.
When I said I was going to get my name changed, I told her, she was like, you gonna get your name changed? I felt like she was like trying to stop me or something. Like, you gonna get your name changed? Like, you sure you? And I'm like, why she? If you do that, that might mess. She was talking like it might mess up like something with my bank or something. I don't want to put no words in her mouth, but the way she was saying it felt like she was trying to stop me from changing my name because it would mess up something with like credit or something. I don't know. But I'm like, no, I'm gonna get my name changed to Sunkee. You know, that was one thing. It was just little things that she would do that made me feel uncomfortable. Not only that, we went to Slut Wall. Okay. You know, goddamn well, my brand, I do have a brand. I am a name. And let me first make very clear, I don't need nobody, never have needed anybody to boost me up and under that. I've been doing this shit longer than her, anybody else. A lot of people that I've been doing this shit wrong. Yeah. Let's keep it 100. Let's keep it real. I'm not taking nothing from her either. She was doing her thing. She's still doing her thing. I'm not here to bash her and say, oh, bitch, that's not me. What I'm saying is, there were things that she did that made me uncomfortable.
Okay.
When we went to Slut Walk, we had a great time. However, there was things that she did that a lot of people came to me about afterwards. If you go back and look at the video on YouTube, you can see she got the cussing out the security guard because they were telling us to leave. It was a lot of things. It was just like, okay, this is my brand. This is my name. I didn't come out here to cuss the damn security out. You know, we had Amber Rose Slut Walk. Like, I have a name.
And right.
When I wanted to work with her, I saw that there were things that she was doing that I said, you know what? This is not me. This is not me. And I'm true to myself. I'm not into sex work. I'm not going to act like I have not never done it, because I've done it before and have been paid by millionaires. I'm not going to sit up here and lie and make it seem like I'm just perfect now. I have done things when I needed it, but that's not the way that I want to go. Okay. Jaguar does sex work. I don't know if she still do, but I understand everybody got to get their money. So I'm not even here to bash that. But she was like, you want to come to San Diego with somebody I want you to fuck with? You know, I guess she was trying to get me involved in some type of threesome or something. The guy wanted me to be involved.
Oh, wow.
And in my mind, I'm like, you know, I'm already HIV positive. Not to say, you can have sex and do what you do if you're HIV positive, but it's just I learned from my mistakes, and I don't want to be the type to be out there giving myself to know anybody. That's not my style. Right. If that's somebody's style, fine, whatever. I'm not going to bash you, but that's just not me. Right. So I told her, and she was like, I'm going to have to get you out of all this scary stuff. And I'm like, what? So now I'm scary? Why are you calling me scared? So I told her, everything I'm telling you, I told her, she can vouch for that. So she can say whatever she wants to say after this, because I'm not going to keep going back and forth, bitch. I'm not. I'm grown as fuck. I'm 32 years old. I'm not going to keep going back and forth with a grown-ass woman. When I tried to call you, and when I tried to call you, rather listen to your fans who you kept sending to my page, coming at me for no fucking reason, all because of something I had already told her. I told her this, that I felt uncomfortable about the things that I did. But when I came to social media and people was asking me, I didn't come to social media. I felt like she was sending people my way because people saw that we wasn't talking to each other no more. So
and I respect your honesty and your candor. Keep going.
This ain't no too much information. It is what it is. I'm 100 about mine. I don't know about y'all in the comment section, but I'm 100 about mine. And my name ain't finna be on no list without me not saying nothing or addressing nothing, because my name shouldn't be on that list. I didn't send nobody to your page. Stop with the bullshit. You're too old for that shit. We old. Ain't nobody got time for that shit. I know I don't. But ain't nobody gonna fuck with me either. So I'm not really worried about this list, whatever. That's promo for me as far as I'm concerned. But ain't nobody gonna fuck with me. Right. Or they gonna put their hands on me. Fuck this internet shit. But it's not, it shouldn't even have to be that deep to even like, it shouldn't even have to be that deep. Anyway. She after that, she told me like I was scary because I didn't want to be involved. So there was somebody that I knew. I'm not gonna mention her name, but she was a very close. She was like a sister to me. She's from Africa. A lot of people saw me hanging with her. She had blonde hair, very very beautiful girl. We went to a party. I knew she was kind of like new out here. Mm-hmm. She was doing coke, and I'm not gonna lie. I know we grown. You can't stop nobody from doing nothing they want to do. They want to have fun. They want to have fun. However, the type of person that I am, if I'm around people I know that we don't know, and I see that somebody's giving you, something just didn't feel right to me. I can feel things, and something did not feel right in that house at that party. And I was trying to look out for my sister, because that's like my fucking sister. Like, I really fucked with this girl, for real, for real.
Right.
To the point I actually cried. I got a video still on YouTube behind the shit while I dressed, and I put it on private, because I was like, fuck it, I don't want this shit. I don't even want to be involved in no more. But I cried behind this situation because of what happened. Not because I'm weak. I cried because I was hurt.
Oh, wow.
My homegirl was doing coke. She knew that I don't do drugs. I felt some kind of way about that. Mm-hmm. And I didn't really have nobody to talk. It affected me in a way that I felt like, this is my bitch. Girl, you don't know these people. Like, be careful. Like, you don't know what they cut in their coat. You don't know these people. And right. I felt like something just didn't feel right. Something did not feel right. I know I saw them how they was looking, and I felt like it was like they was praying on her or some shit. Something just, to me, it didn't feel right. So I ended up going home or whatever, and I felt some kind of way about that. I told the person I'm talking about that I told her that I felt some kind of way about you doing coke. I know you're wrong, sis, but I just didn't want to see you get hurt. That's all. I didn't want to see you get hurt. That's all.
You looking out
for me? I went to Jaguar, told Jaguar, because I knew Jaguar. I introduced this person to Jaguar. I told her that my friend, I told her about what's going on. I'm like, I didn't really have nobody to talk to, you know, and my friend was doing this, and I didn't want to go. I didn't really know how to go to my friend about it because, you know, I didn't want to make her feel bad for something that she did, but I just wanted to make sure that she was okay being in L.A. with people she don't know. I know L.A. It's a dark side of L.A. And if you're not careful, people will suck you into some shit that's very dark and demonic. So although I can't be nobody, let me first say, I wasn't trying to be her mama. I was trying to be a sister, and I was trying to be a friend. In my heart and in my intention, that's what my intentions were. So I told Jaguar, thinking I could confide in her, and I felt like I could. I mean, it's like, we talk about a lot of stuff. She knew the person.
Right.
So I found that right after that, somebody had wrote the person I'm talking about, you need to watch Sunkee. She going around telling people that you do coke. And I know Jaguar was the only person that I told. So I'm like, I said, Jaguar, what's going on? Because, like, I'm not trying to put her business out there, but I told my friend, I did go to Jaguar. I did, because I didn't want to hurt your feelings or whatever, but I was just trying to look out for you. That was my intention. And right. even this person that didn't talk and everything, we good and everything. I don't talk to her no more, but we have made peace about that or whatever. So,
okay.
And she was like, well, it wasn't me. And I'm like, I'm going to say it was somebody else at the party who saw it. But I know that I personally felt in my spirit that I felt like, because I know, I'm going to say why I'm in a minute.
Okay.
Jaguar didn't even know this person, she didn't even know this person that long, okay? Next thing you know, I'm talking to my producer on the phone. I introduced this person to Jaguar one time. Next thing you know, Jaguar and my friend going live, going down the road. So I'm not gonna lie, at that time I felt some kind of way, because it's like, damn, y'all left me out, like y'all just met and y'all clicking up, like
what the fuck
is going on? It didn't feel right in my stomach. So I'm talking to my producer. I told my producer, something don't feel right. He said, Sunkee, get off the phone with me right now and call her. If you don't feel right, call her. Okay. So I called her.
Right.
And this is the truth. I can't make this shit up. I ain't got time. Like I said, bitch, I'm dropping music. I ain't got time for this shit, but I ain't gonna let nobody keep bullying and fucking with my name. Right. Thinking I'm not gonna step up and say something. Because I'm uphill when it comes to the bullshit. But, so I called her and I told her, like, what's going on? Why y'all, damn, like, y'all couldn't hit a bitch up? So come to find out, they was going to go do sex work because I guess I wasn't the type to be, I kind of low-key felt like a pimp or some shit. Not a pimp, but I felt like I was being like, I don't know, I can't explain what I'm trying to say, but it's just, she had me to come to San Diego because I rolled with her, but I told her I wasn't going to do nothing sexually, which I didn't. But she was trying to get me to come on that trip to do some sexual activity with her, like I said. So after that, I felt like maybe she felt like I wasn't the type to do that. So my homegirl at the time, she was trying to get her money and stuff like that. Her Jaguar clicked up. They wanted to go do what they was going to go and do whatever they was going to do it with. And I felt something. At first, I didn't know what they was doing. But when I saw them together, I'm like, well, damn. That's just like if you meet somebody, you close to somebody, and next thing you know, you see them going live together. Are you going to feel some kind of way or not? Honestly.
Yeah, I will.
So it was weird to me because I'm like, damn, how the fuck y'all ain't even known each other that long? How y'all going live? They going live. Like it didn't feel right to me. I felt uncomfortable. It's a lot of things that she did that made me uncomfortable. So if I'm saying that I felt uncomfortable about a lot of things that you've done, stop trying to make it seem like I'm hating on you or I'm coming for you, because that's not it. If I was coming for you, I would have never reached out to you from the beginning.
Right.
So not only that, like I said, it was a situation we went to the slut wall. She got to cuss some people out just doing the most. Y'all know Jaguar. She can be funny as hell. Like, I'm not here to take nothing away from her. I'm not going to lie. Even now, I've seen things, and I ain't going to lie. I laugh because she be funny. That's just me. Okay. If something is funny to me, even if they are enemy, I'm going to laugh because I'm a funny-ass person. I'm a real-ass bitch with some shit. But to me, if something is funny, I'm going to laugh. But when...
What?
But... It was a lot of things that she did. I'm like, I was side-eyed, and I'm like, okay, this is weird to me. So I began to push back. I pushed back. Jaguar, I'm not going to lie, Jaguar gave me money when I didn't have it. We went to the casino.
So she gave you money?
What they going to do for that dick or whatever that shit was called.
Right. But I think that was, you know, in my
mind. Yeah, she gave me money. She gave me money.
But that was more like, I think that was more like, oh, here's some money because I know I'm going to get it back later because I'm going to turn these tricks or something together. That was a
money. Sorry, I'm trying to prop my camera up. You said what?
But see, looking at, from what I'm hearing, that sounded like it was money to say, oh, okay, look, I'm going to give you this money, but, you know, we're going to turn these tricks later together, so I'm going to get my money back on something. Like,
I don't know. I honestly don't know, but that's what I'm saying. You don't really know people. But in my mind, honestly, what I'm learning about is that I should have kept it business. Like, remember when you got on the phone, we talked one time, and you was like, this is not show friendship, it's show business. And ever since you said that to me, it stuck with me. And you are absolutely correct. And what I'm learning now is that everybody, I can't, that, like I said, I'm going to be honest with myself. There were times I tried to make friendship with a lot of people because I was in a vulnerable place. And she know this. There were times where I was being, people were sending death threats. She saw all this. People were sending death threats to me. Courtney Barnes, he know who he is, the one that the pizza burger dude from Mississippi was sending me death threats for no fucking reason because he didn't like me. There was a lot of people in the community, a few people in the community who was aiming at me. And she knew this. She knew this. So after that, people was asking me stuff. The same stuff that I was telling people who was coming to me asking about why we weren't cool on live. They went back and sent her a video or something. Then she blew it up and just like started going trying to lay me out. I'm like, what the fuck? Like, everything I said, I told you.
Oh, wow.
So you can let these fans boost your motherfucking head over everything I'm telling you. I told you every time you made me feel uncomfortable. I told you the only thing I didn't mention to her was about the slut walk thing. I never said nothing about that, but that was something I held on to because now there was a lot of people who watched that video who was just like, okay, she was doing the most. And I'm like, well, that's Jaguar. I took up. I defended. Y'all don't even know I defended Jaguar multiple times because right. I fucked with her.
Right.
That's- but it was a lot of people saying you to let her go, and I'm like, well, nah, she cool. She cool people. She ain't did nothing to me. But as time went on, it was a lot of things that she did that made me uncomfortable. That's all I'm saying. It was never no hate from my end. It was never no shade from my end. It was just certain things she did that made me feel uncomfortable. So like I said, if you're going to equate hate with me feeling uncomfortable, then that's on your motherfucking ass. Because I never said I want to fight you. I never said that you, it was never to that extent. You know, like when it's beef, just like with the situation with, you know, I think I saw the other girl that came and her, like, it wasn't like I was in the car trying. It was never like that. It was for what? But ain't nobody gonna put their motherfucking hands on me either. So, that I do know. And I'm learning to speak up for myself. At one point, I stayed quiet about this shit for a long time. And I'm like, you know what? I'm starting to feel like bitches trying to low-key bully me over this social media shit. So I'm going to say what I need to say. And don't, for the ones who try to say, oh, well, you wrong. How can somebody bully you? Yes, people can be cyberbullied. Yes, people can. Yes, they can.
Definitely.
But I'm not going to let nobody have my name on some list. Like I'm sending people over there. Tell me when the fuck you seen me even on live talking about I sent somebody to her page or y'all go over there and attacked her. No, I didn't. I never will because that's not me. However, there have been people coming to my page up there talking about I bought my blue check and she's saying I bought my blue check, which I didn't. It was earned. And if that was the case, like I said, if everybody, they said the same thing about you. But like I said, if you can buy a blue check, everybody have one. So,
them $10,000 and shit, they just got, everybody in mama had one, but I ain't even tripping. If you Google me, you'll find me everywhere from the New York Times to the New Orleans Times, Picayune. But I ain't gonna do that with the people. You heard me?
Right.
I've not only just written a book, but I've also been in the bounce industry for 20 years. I've also too, you heard me, not only being quoted by the New York Times, a reputable New Orleans, and the local papers, but I've also been on TV several times. People don't even know about that.
Yes.
I've also spoken in front of congressmen and senators about prison rape.
You can't everybody can't just get no blue check. I have been on multiple, I know what it takes to get through. It took me a while to get verified. And like I said, bitch, ain't nobody gonna be spending no $10,000 or however much to get no motherfucking blue check. Bitch, I can use that to put that into my music. I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna wait and be patient. And when I woke up one day, I had it. I didn't even know I was verified.
My daughter called, woke me up and told me I was verified. I didn't even know. But at the same time, I knew this. If I had $10,000, it wouldn't go in a blue check. I'll go get this surgery and get this stomach sucked out of me.
You better know what to say, because the blue check gonna come anyway. I knew it was coming. As a matter of fact, the girl I'm talking about who was from Africa, she got verified before me, and she was telling me what to do to get verified. Because I was asking, I'm like, girl, she was like, it's gonna be easy for you, Sunkee. You already a celebrity. You a name, bitch. It's gonna be a walk in the park. But just keep applying, do what you keep doing. And sure enough, it took a minute. I ain't gonna lie. First, I thought I wasn't gonna get verified, to be honest. Next thing I woke up, and fans were like, oh, you got verified. I'm like, oh, shit, bitch, I got verified, bitch. You know, so that's how it happened. I'm thankful I worked my ass off, been doing this shit, been an OG in this motherfucking ass, been. Nobody coattail. If anything, bitches be trying to ride my motherfucking coattail, because, bitch, I've been doing this shit way before I even transitioned. Go look up Diggy doing search, and you'll see I don't have no points.
You'll see several interviews and stuff like that. I quote Diggy do sometimes when I be talking about
Diggy. But let me say this. Me and Jaguar have had some really fun. I'm not going to sit up here and lie. We've had some really great times. We had a lot of funny times. There are videos I go back and watch. I even repost a lot. If you follow me, you'll see I repost the video because I don't have no hate in my heart towards this lady. But there were certain things that she did that made me feel uncomfortable. So I decided to bag back. Next thing you know, people coming on my page. I felt like they was being sent to me. Maybe they weren't, but that's what it felt like, because it's like, where the fuck these people coming from? People was asking, y'all ain't together no more. What's going on? I'm like, well, there was some things she made that I felt like it was some stuff she did that made me feel uncomfortable. This is what I'm telling people. It was things she did that made me feel uncomfortable. And I'm just at a distance now. I ain't got time to be over in somebody else's circumference that where I'm feeling some kind of way or whatever. How have I felt? So, yeah, it was pretty much all I'm saying is I felt some kind of way because I felt like it was certain things she did to make me feel uncomfortable. That's just all I'm saying. I never said I was going to fight her or anything like that. To me, it was never that deep. But like I said, nobody going to put their motherfucking hands on Sunkee. That's not going to happen. And I'm not saying I'm going to put my hands on her because it's not that deep. But people and the fans and everybody, they like to bullshit up and try to make something that is not. I've tried to reach out to this lady several times. She got on her live and said, I ain't talking unless I get a check or some shit. That's what they said she said. So she wanted to entertain this shit. So I'm really not trying to entertain that. You know how long it took me to even come on here to do what I'm doing right now?
Right. But I'm glad you did get it out because I...
Yes, I'm glad I am like too, because I'm not going to let nobody keep putting... You take that list, you, shit, and keep it up on. It don't matter, because while y'all here, make sure y'all go stream Piss on the Flow. And this mixtape that's about to come, I ain't doing no more talking. Everything I'm doing, I'm putting it in with the lyrics. The fuck? I'm putting it in my songs. I ain't got time. But the spirit keep telling me it's time to speak. I'm very spiritual. Spirit keep telling me, not only like with her, but with your family, your mama, everybody. It's time to speak. Stop holding back. I ain't holding back no more.
Sunkee, I believe that you didn't do this woman anything outside of just falling back from her. And that was
that's all I did. It was almost like she got me. Somebody, she must have got mad because I won't fuck her with her no more. Go back and watch that slut wall video. The whole time I'm pumping her. I'm like, come on, Jag. I really fuck with Jaguar. Like in my heart, I really fuck with her. For real. Can't nobody try to make. I see some of her stuff even to this day and still laugh. I don't fuck. We don't fuck with each other. But I'm not here saying, oh, bitch, when I see you on the street, it's gonna cut for what? Bitch, the fuck for what?
Right.
So. All I'm saying is more power to her. If they take anything from what I'm saying out of my truth, because this is my truth, and this is what happened to me, then that's on y'all. But you can't go back and say that I said a thing. You can be messy, but this video ain't gonna lie. So even if she wanna talk to this day, if I see her in the streets right now, I'm not gonna be messy and look at her crazy or nothing like that. But just don't, like I said, don't put your hands on me. Don't, if I look like I'm being threatened, it's gonna be a problem. But I don't feel like it's to that extent, because to me, it ain't beef. It never was beef. People made it beef.
Right, yeah.
So, but yeah, other than that, it's the energy just felt very dark to me when I was in company with her at times, and I just was just like, okay, this ain't, it's okay if you want to work with somebody, you say, you know what, I changed my mind. I don't think this is a great, you know, you can bag back if you want to, right?
Right, definitely.
That's what I did. So why was it a problem for me to bag the fuck back? Why was it a problem?
It's not a problem, sister. I don't know where that came from. I don't know how you made it. Everybody on that list is have some.
I feel like it's like some bully type shit. You know, yeah, I laughed at some of the shit you said about her because the shit was funny. I laughed at anything that's funny. But bitch, honestly, I feel like this could be karma low key, because people coming at her, it's like, you sent all them people to come at me, baby. You sent all them people to come at me for nothing. That when you didn't see no proof, no nothing, why I really was coming for your head. You sent all them people over there, like, I'm over here, like I'm saying, I'm finna put a gun, like I'm finna shoot you. Baby, please. I ain't scared of nobody at all. Nobody puts no fear in Sunkee Angel at all.
I do not believe you did her nothing. I believe that I'm karma for everything that she's done to other people and all the shit that she's done. I believe I'm her karma. That's my mind. That's what I feel like in my mind. Not her. Excuse me. I respect my trans sisters, and I will refer to all of my trans sisters as female. But this one here, I'm sorry. I just cannot give it to him. But anyway, I refer, so, but it's like, man, I'm his karma. And he wrong for what he doing to you, and I don't like it. You have done nothing to him, and you're not even in that type of you don't even beat everybody on that.
Tell me, Shakie, honestly, tell me, yes, I have wronged a few people who came in my comment section coming for me, yes, but honestly, tell me, when have you seen me on my live saying what I'm going to do to her, y'all want to attack her page? I don't believe in people's pages getting shut down, because my page was shut down. And I know when you work hard, I don't give a fuck if it is beef. I ain't gonna send nobody to try to get nobody. That's just not in my nature, no fucking way. Her page got shut down on Facebook, and I was trying to see what I could do to help her. Like, my page was shut down. I actually went, if it's a video on YouTube, I went to Facebook. I went to the headquarters and pulled up on there and got my motherfucking page. So I understand when your page get lost. I'm trying to help her to see what I can do to get her page back. Like, cause she had a lot of followers, so I'm like, bitch, I'm not the type to try to, that ain't in my nature to try to get nobody to pay shit down. I'm just gonna keep it 100. I don't believe in that type of shit, because that shit comes back. What you send it to the lives of others is coming back. And the scary part is that you don't know how the fuck it's coming back. So, bitch, I'm careful about my karma.
Right.
So that's why I said, Spirit told me when it's time to talk, and that's what I'm doing, talking. I have not said, even now, I ain't said nothing, said I'm gonna do nothing to her or nothing, but I'm not scared of no motherfucking body. It was a long time I said I won't say nothing, but I'm not scared of nobody.
Sisters, I'm glad you let it out. I'm glad you got it out of your system as far as how you were feeling, because obviously this was a situation that's bothering you, and people come and telling you, oh, listen, you see your names on a list, shots fired. That's almost like threatening
shots
you.
Shots fired at who? Shots fired at what?
I don't know. I didn't
write it. Baby, please, shots fired at who, though? Because, baby, my name shouldn't even be on that fucking list. I ain't did nothing to that damn girl. My name should not even be on that. Jaguar, don't play with me. My name should not be on that fucking list. I don't even know why you playing like that. I ain't did shit to you. Stop it. The fuck is you talking about? Put my name on the list. Talking about they sent people. What the fuck is you talking about? When the fuck have I sent anybody? Tell me who the people I'm sending to your page. Girl, you just want to throw my name on that list or whatever you had to say. I don't know what you got a problem with me, fuck, baby. I ain't did shit. Fuck out of here. You think I ain't gonna come to my defense of my name because you got my name on your page? Fuck out of here. This shit been going on for too long, since 2017, bitch. I'm gonna speak up when it comes to my name, period. So I don't even look at you being messy right now. I honestly felt like it was a perfect thing, because I didn't know my name was on no fucking list. But since my name is on that list, I'm going to be the one to come on here and address it. And if anybody got a motherfucking problem, they can address me. Bitch, you got to ask. I just posted a post where I tagged her. But I saw that, I think her page was, I don't know if she blocked me. Well, why the fuck is you blocking me? I'm not asking.
She blocked you. Her page ain't gone. She blocked you.
So like I said, yes, it's promo. Piss on the floor. Because that's what the fuck I'm finna do. I'm finna continue to piss on these hoes. I ain't got time for the motherfucking drama, the fuck, bitch. Stream piss on the floor while y'all here. I just made over 1 million views on TikTok. And I'm pissing on these hoes. They ain't gagged and they gargling.
Congratulations.
I ain't got time to be on here. Oh, yeah, she's... I'm finna come meet you. Hold on. Where you at? Who the fuck got time for that? Who the fuck got time? Not me. Bitch, it ain't that deep. It never was. I felt uncomfortable, like I said, about certain things that she did. I went to her and told her it was certain things that she, every time she did something made me feel uncomfortable. I told her, why would you say that? Well, she told me, the reason why I told you she was scared is because that's what people would say. Like, people would say stuff like that to me. Like, and I'm like, okay. Like, okay. You know, but honestly, like I said, we had some great times. We did. I've reminisced. I'm a real bitch. We had great times. We did. And we laughed. We kiki. We had a great time. And I try to remember. I remember and think about the good just like I think about the bad. But yeah. I'm not trying to be involved in all this shit. Let me do me. Keep my name out of this bullshit. Because I got a fan base, too. That's strong as fuck.
Right.
Strong.
Right.
And they ain't going to play when it comes to me. I got people that, as I hear, they ain't going to play when it comes to me. They know I don't fuck with nobody. I've been told, anybody fuck with you, don't. But it ain't that type of part. If I said it ain't that deep. Right. I don't have to go that far. But don't play with me either, because you pulling me into something that ain't got shit to do with me.
Right.
But anyway, that's really all I got to say. Now, anybody got anything they need to say that's on there? I ain't entertaining no more shit. Like I said, ain't no beef over here. Anybody, I'm saying, you hearing it out of Sunkee mouth, since y'all always asking questions, trying to see what the fuck going on. You hearing it out of my mouth now, okay? Ain't no beef with Jab. I don't got no problem with her. Whatever she got, that's her problem. I ain't got no problem with her. Never have. If I did, I would have never even tried to collab with the damn girl.
Let me say this. First of all, thank you for coming on. I thank you for being
honest. Thank you for inviting me.
And I thank you for being honest about what it is that transpired and what you actually said and how you actually feel about it. Because sometimes that's hard to do, especially with somebody with how she is and how menacing that he can be with all that. But right. At the same time, so I do respect that, because let me tell you something. I'm going to tell you what's going to happen. He's so messed up. He's going to blame you for coming and tell your truth about how you feel.
He can do that. You think I ain't prepared? Baby, listen, you think I'm not prepared for the shits? But what I'm saying is, he can do whatever he want to do, long as nobody put their hands on me. I don't fuck that talking shit. I ain't got time for none of that. Because there's been a lot of talking on the internet. I ain't got time for that. But if I feel like my life is being threatened, I'm going to handle mine, period. But it's not that serious. To me, it's not. I don't know. I tried to talk. I came to her a couple times, tried to talk to her. She didn't want to talk. She said, oh, I ain't talking. You got to pay me. I'm like, okay. When the fans were starting up shit, I came to her. I called her line and tried to talk to her. She didn't want to talk. So it was like, okay, well, bitch, okay. Then I'm not going to kiss your ass. I'm not going to kiss nobody's ass. The fuck out of here. Bitch, I'm Sunkee, just like you, Jaguar. I got a name. Been doing this shit. Certified blue check that I did not buy. I earned it. So whatever. I don't know what the fuck. So y'all can quiet that shit down. Quiet all that motherfucking noise down. Because, bitch, I'm going to speak when it comes to my name being on something like this. When my name is involved in some shit like this, I wasn't going to say nothing, but she actually put my name in writing for nothing at that.
Right. I'll be telling
you. How you gonna blame me for something I ain't even did to you? I ain't did nothing to you. And let's just say I did. It ain't that goddamn serious for you to be running and still running with this shit all the way into 2020. It ain't like I'm at your motherfucking throat. You don't see me on live going the fuck off like Shamar and everybody else. I ain't been on live with her. I don't go live with her. I don't even be thinking about this damn girl. So people bring her the fuck up.
Right, definitely.
So
definitely.
Anyway, are y'all hungry? Do y'all want something to eat? Cause bitch, I just went to the motherfucking grocery store and I'm about to eat good.
So I'm going to get my food stamps tomorrow. I can't wait.
Yes, baby. Send me some, goddamn it, bitch. I'm going to eat. I'm hungry. You know what I'm saying? But, like, much love to everybody. Much love to her. Much love to you. I don't have no hate. I'm not trying to have no hate in my heart towards people. However, I don't fuck with certain people. And I got that right to not fuck with people if I feel like they made me. It's a lot of people that made me feel uncomfortable.
Yeah.
People you know, names, big names, have said things to make me feel uncomfortable in their presence. Right. That I still be trying not to talk about. But it's like, I'm at this point now, bitch, I ain't high shit. If I feel like it's something I need to say, I'm going to say it.
That's the and I believe in that. I believe you're gonna ruffle some feathers, but I believe at the end of the day, you don't owe them nothing. Who you owe is the people that do love and support you. You owe them the truth. You owe them the full story. That's what you owe.
Yes.
I tell this to people all the time. I don't answer to nobody. I don't care if this person don't like it. I don't care if that person like it. I got to go with the sippers. That's who I owe it to. That's the only person I owe something to. And collectively, is the sippers. That's who I owe any explanation about anything for. And we do have to. Just be mindful of that, like about these people that we sometimes idolize. Even when we come to working with her and doing stuff with her, I respect what you was trying to do, but at the same time, is you have people that love you. You have people that support you regardless. And so this is who you answer to. That's how you answer to. And I realized that through a lot of times during this process that, and even when we were talking about, like, it's the business, this is the business friendship, and this is not the business friendship, this is the music business. And so it goes into that because guess what? If this is the music business, you have a boss. But your boss is collectively the people that love and support what you do.
My boss is my producer. That's my man. He's my manager and my producer. He know. I talked to him about this shit. But I told him, I'm at this point, Bruce. He signed to Sony Music. This man that worked with Michael Jackson, some of the biggest people in the game. He know I ain't with that bullshit. I didn't come out here for no motherfucking drama. I didn't come out here to be trying to fight. I'm trying to connect, trying to really put shit together. And to be honest, if I can open the door for the next bitch, if I can, I will. I recorded Jaguar's whole fucking music video. She came to my studio. I recorded it, did the shot the video on every goddamn thing. And actually, what I could have charged, I could have taxed that ass. Let's keep with the work that I do. I really could have taxed the ass. But for what? She trying to get her money just like I'm trying to get my money. I'm not trying to charge you. I see we both trying to get money. For what?
Right.
So I honestly wanted to see Jaguar excel. And that's the God's honest truth. I honestly wanted to see Jaguar excel. I wanted to connect with her from one trans woman to the next trans woman. To why not? We both two big names in LA. Why not come together and do some big ass shit and break the charts? Why not?
Why not?
That's how I honestly felt in my name. And it wasn't even that in the beginning. It was just like, okay, I want to try to see if I can bridge this gap. Let me see if I can reach out to her to see if she give me a shout out for I'm Not a Label. She did that. I'm like, okay, she seemed like she cool people. So she sent me the video. If you go look at I'm Not a Label, you will see her at the end. She said, hi, I'm Jaguar Evermore. I was painted with all the colors in the winds, and now I'm Not a Label. She slayed that shit. I'm like, yes, bitch. So after that, I'm like, okay, she cool. We started talking, like I said, and we collabed. And we was trying to collab. We did It, the Tranny in the Hood. We did the Scary Move in the Hood and everything. And let me say this. Let me keep it even more real.
Keep it real, sister.
Just to show people how I didn't even want it to be a comparison or competition, because I'm not really about that. I know people don't try to compare you and stuff like that. Right. If you look at the It, the Tranny in the Hood movie cover, I put her in front of me. And right. I did that for a reason. You know why I did that? Because I wanted to show that I don't mind being in the back. I don't mind putting people in the front. That was, and I'm telling you what's in my heart now.
Right.
You can't nobody tell me, but if you go look at the cover for the movie, you will see that I put her in front of me.
Right.
I was in the back. So can't nobody tell me, try to make it like I'm some hater, like I'm trying to, cuss for what? That ain't, I'm not that type of person. I really was trying to fuck with her. But anyway, I ain't going to keep going in circles. But I said what I said.
Let me leave you with this last piece of advice, and this is for anybody. Real quick. I don't know why we as humans made selfish a bad word and look it out for yourself. Because in the case of you, look, let me say something. Huh? She's going to be selfish. Anybody that you come in contact with is going to be selfish. So if you looking out for her, if you looking out for her and she looking out for her, who looking out for you? You have to look out for self. That's your job. You have to look out for yourself. There's nothing wrong with you to protect yourself. You can't help nobody until you make it. And the only way to make it is to identify and pay attention and to do yourself. That's the only way you're going to do it. You're not going to make it doing Jaguar. Jaguar or anybody, you're not going to make it doing Shakie. You can only make it doing Sunkee.
But you know what? I know what you're saying is true. You are absolutely correct. But I felt like at that time, it was okay to collab. People can collab.
It's okay to collab. I just wanted to show. If the collaboration is one-sided to where it's not an and, it's like you're a side note, you're doing nothing for self. You're looking out for the other person. By sitting in the background, and I'm not trying to be shady, I'm just being real. And people don't like this hit of truth, but this is the truth. If you're looking, you putting her in the front of something that you probably have the most diction over at the same time, that's a disservice to you and the people you really do work for, and that's the people that support you. There will never be a situation. Let me tell you something. They had a show down here today called Summer Jam.
Right.
With BJ and all these people, and they wanted me to be on the show. I said, well, you have to put my picture in front of the flyer, this position, this is how I want it to be. And if you can't do that, I'm not going to be on it. Per blank period. I owe it to the Sippers to show them that the fruit of the labor that they invested with me, which is their time, not only their time, but their money, not only their money, but just the whole mantra of being in part of my thing, to say, if we're going to be on something, we're going to be at the front. That's what we're going to be. If you can't put me right there, I can't do it. Per blank period. And that's just that's just the case may be. I don't owe it to the people that's giving it. Whoever else was on the flyer, I don't owe them nothing. Them bitches never did like me. Them bitches don't support me. Them bitches, I always tell the people that repost what I say. So repost the comments, the like, the shares, the $10 cash shares when my black ass hungry. And you know what I'm saying? That's who I owe answers to. And so I owe it to them to be, if I tell us, listen, sisters, we high class now. And we all need to be helping up. And then I show them a picture with my little, where I'm at the back of the motherfucker, you got me fucked up. That's not where we're going to go. And so at the same time, you did a disservice to us people that love you and are fans of you. I am one of those people by putting this monster up front when knowing that we really want to see you. You don't owe them, you don't owe these people to nothing to make them whatever.
No, I know what you're saying, but I just want to say, I know what you're saying. I just want you to know my intentions. You follow me? Like,
I love your
intentions. That's all I'm saying. Like, but, it was my intentions.
The homeless shelter is filled with good intentions. And good-hearted people. And everybody trying to look out for somebody else. You better take care of yourself. I love you. The live is about to end. We got about a minute left.
Okay.
I appreciate you for coming. And as always, you're welcome. You're a friend of the show and a friend of the Sip Nation. And we have always, we love you, sister.
Thank you so much. I love you guys in the comments. Even the ones down there talking shit, I love y'all too. Because that's what y'all gonna do.
Thank you so much.
But yeah, I love you.
Appreciate it.
Okay.
Y'all heard it for yourself. The live is about to end. I'm going to lay my fat ass down. I'm bug naked again. Jaguar just is just a sex work, trying to get this girl to come do sex work with her. Girl, this girl is a entertainer. What the fuck? Jaguar, you was a, Mike. Hey Google, turn off all the lights.
Okay, turning off 6 lights.
Wow. that's how you do that. I ain't got to do nothing, man. I ain't got to do nothing. Oh, it's dark in here, bitch. Titty bob one time. Okay. Bop, 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 bop. Titty bop. I titty bop. Jaguar did all this sex, trying to do this sex work. Girl, ain't nobody trying to do this sex work with you, girl. The fuck? Man. So listen, y'all. Full sex. I love y'all. We'll talk to y'all tomorrow.